This blue hand looks like this 1 minute ago. This is made through a fascinating process called flame bluing, or heat bluing, which is a traditional watchmaking technique that has been in use as early as the 16th century. And once you understand what is happening with the hand, you'll see why its effect is so magical. In the next few minutes, we'll show you how to do this the traditional way, with a flame. Let's get started. So what is flame bluing? In the simplest term, it's just heating the hand until it changes colour. But why does it change colour? Turns out the science behind it is quite intriguing. By heating the hand, a layer of ferrous oxide forms on it. This layer causes an effect called thin film interference, which is the same reason for the colours on soap bubbles. It'll take another whole video to explain it. But in short, the thickness of this oxide film changes how the light is reflected. So a layer of certain thickness will reflect light as a certain colour. And as a result, as you heat the hand, you'll see the colour transitions through straw, brown, purple, blue, light blue, and grey. The specific colour corresponds to the specific temperature the metal piece is at. So for a nice flame blue, we're aiming at around 310 degrees centigrade or 590 degrees Fahrenheit. But to get that perfect blue, there are many factors you have to get right. Here are a few botched attempts at flame bluing. You'll know what causes them in a moment, and by then you'll understand why manually flame blued hands are nowadays almost only seen in luxury watches. Okay, now you should have a pretty good idea on what flame blue is. Next, I'll show you step by step how you can create the perfect flame blue by yourself. There are three parts to this: setup, hand preparation, and heating. First, let's set up the whole thing. You can use whatever you have at home that suits the purpose, but in this video, we'll be using our DIY kit to demonstrate. Let's take a look at what's inside. We'll take out the heat-resistant mat and tweezers first. This is the bluing tray with a clamp. We'll set it up at a height where the flame can freely and safely move. The heat-resistant mat goes underneath the tray. Inside this bottle are brass filings, which will help us spread the heat evenly. Pour a thin layer onto the bluing tray. Prepare a small amount of distilled water near the bluing tray, as you'll need to quench the hand once it reaches your desired colour. This is the torch. Fill it with butane before using. A white light source will be very helpful in determining the true colour of the hand, so get one ready. We'll talk about its positioning later in this video. With the setup ready, let's do some preliminary practice first. This is to learn how to apply the heat evenly. This is the hottest point of the flame. We want to point this at the bottom of the tray and move it back and forth along the tray. As the brass filings heat up, they'll turn brownish. This colour represents the optimal temperature for flame bluing. As you heat it up more, it will turn to dark purple. This is too hot, and we want to avoid that. The aim is to achieve an even reddish brown across all filings. As it cools down, the filings will turn back to the original colour. So you can do a few more round trips to acclimate yourself. Okay, now let's move on to hand preparation. The first important factor is the surface finish. Bluing itself does not change the finish, so a polished hand stays polished and any blemishes will still be there. I deliberately made a scratch on this hand and then flame blued it. As you can see, the scratch is very much still visible after bluing, so make sure you are perfectly fine with the finish before you proceed. The hands in our kit are polished, so that's one less thing to worry about. Another factor is hygiene. Don't do this yourself. This is just to show you a point. I picked up this hand with my bare hands and then put it straight onto the bluing tray. Did a quick round of heating and this is how it turns out. Not good. What happened is that the grease on my hand interfered with the oxidation, so the blue came out uneven. That's why we only use tweezers to handle the watch hands. If unfortunately you touched a hand, you can clean it using Rodico. With stubborn smudges, use acetone or mineral spirits to clean it. With the hands prepped, you can now begin heating. I like to do this to get a nice bed for bluing. Now, let's put the hand onto the filings. Check that the hand is level and well in contact with the filings along the entire length of it. At this point, position and angle the white light so that it's directed at the hand and you can see both light and shadow on the hand. As you'll see, the boundary between white and black will help us see the colour of the hand easier. I'll hold the torch in one hand and have a pair of tweezers in another. If you're doing this for the first time, I'd recommend using a smaller flame so the process happens more slowly. Do the same motion as we practiced for an even distribution of optimal temperature. When the filings turn brownish, you can pull the flame away or even turn off the flame. This is when the magic happens. Slowly, you should see the colour of the hand start changing. It might be hard to distinguish the colour change, so bring an untreated hand next to it for comparisons. Remember that the first colour should be straw. The sequence of colours is like this, so you might find it useful to save this chart for your reference. So this is the cycle. Bring the heat up, stop heating when the filings are brownish, allow time for the hand to change colour, and resume heating when the filings cool down. It will take some time before it changes through the first colour, but from that point onward, the colour change gets much quicker. So when it reaches purple, the blue can be only seconds away. So it'll help to pull the flame a bit further from the tray to slow down the transition. Once you see the colour you want, pick up the hand and drop it into the water immediately. This will quench the hand and lock in the colour. Pick it out of the water and dry it immediately on a piece of paper towel. If you wait for it to dry, water spots may develop. Dab and don't wipe. The paper fibre could create fine scratches if you wipe. Let's check how we did. I'll check the colour against a white background under a white light. Looks like the colour is a bit on the underside. I'll put it back and heat a tiny bit more. I'll be careful with this because you cannot reverse the bluing process once you've gone past the blue you want. The only way to fix an overheated hand is to sand away the oxide layer, repolish and re-blue. That's why it's a good idea to have multiple sets of hands with you. Okay, we're done reheating the hand. Let's see how it is. Blemish-free and even colour. This is good. Now I'll repeat this on the other hands. There's now one more challenge. You'll need to try to match the blue of the first hand. So compare the colour with the first hand from time to time. This is the set of hands that we managed to blue. Looks pretty good. Now I can install them onto my watch. If you're not sure how to do that, check out our guide first. Trust me, you don't want to ruin your perfectly blued hands with a bad hand installation. So the final result looks like this. And this is made simply with a flame. But there are lots more you can play with. The beauty of doing it by yourself the manual way is that you can get creative with it. Things like blowing screws instead of hands, blowing hands in different colours, or even a gradient effect like this. You just need to heat one end more than the other to achieve this effect. Yeah, so that's flame bluing. It's fun, try it out. If you manage to blue some hands, post the result in the comments down below, we'd love to see it. And if you want to see me do more creative mods using this technique, let me know in the comments as well. So that's it. Thank you for watching, and if you enjoyed this DIY watch guide, be sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, have fun with your watch.